are so lucky to have Michael Veitch on our panel all morning. He is a man of many talents. Take a look back at some of his amazing career.
He's the big man of Australian comedy.
That's what they're saying in TV Week.
Just make a hard left up to it.
1985, he joined fellow comedians Magda Zabanski and Rob Sitch to create The D-Generation.
We're now playing Coach Sister Perpetua, did her groin.
He then moved on to Fast Forward and Full Frontal.
And you know, I was extremely musical in my youth. Ever heard of Fiddler on the Roof?
Oh, yes, it's the thing for you and that.
No, I just used to do it a lot.
After tickling funny bones across the country on TV and in movies, he's now an accomplished author, proving there are no limits to this giggling Gert's talent.
Where do you come up? How do you come up with your characters? That Kelvin Cunnington, for example, with that laugh. Can you still do the laugh?
You said it.
Where did it come from?
He came about actually when we were on radio with the D-Generation people, and I can't name who the person was, but the panel operator. It was in the days when you had like the person who pushed all the buttons and played the records and things. Every time Tom and Santo and I would make some vague innuendo that we didn't even realise, say hard, he'd go. And he wasn't even supposed to be on air, but it was bleeding off the microphones. And we were saying, what? Oh, you know, you're making... No, we weren't actually making a joke. But we thought, hang on, this is a character. So, yes. And eventually what we did, we actually managed to record his little laugh and we got it on a separate cart and we kept playing it long after he'd been sacked.
Oh.
And that developed into this snotty-nosed little... office.
Did he know that he was the inspiration?
He probably does now.
He's a poor, lowly paid employee and he was spotted by a nationally
crucified. He wasn't, because he actually went on to be quite a respected broadcaster in... I can't tell you.
He's famous now.
He's not famous, but he was certainly well known in Victorian broadcasting
circles.
Does
he still laugh like that?
I haven't checked, but he probably does.
I can't believe the D-Gen's panel operator was Alan Jones.
Hey, we're going to take a look at one of the favourites from Fast Forward, the flight stewards. Take a look at this.
Come fly with me, let's fly away.
Harold, yes, I reckon we should go for the whole 30% increase.
I think we should make it 35.
Okay, we'll make it 40.
All right, let's agree on a 50% increase, all right?
Let's agree a 50% increase on our hairbrush allowance.
Yes.
Okay.
Sophisticated humour, Fast Forward. It really was. It was like very highbrow about it. We just did a lot of it.
I was actually thinking about that. Like, do you think you could actually do that sort of comedy now? Because there's such a huge amount of outrage everywhere. Is it people are more... Are they more sensitive or is it just more social media? Or
look, you know, it would be hard to sort of poke fun. Yeah, you know, it would be very different in this day and age. It would be harder to do that kind of, you know, kind of unfair poking fun.
It's
stereotypes. Yes, look, it is the way of the world. But look, it was never intended to be anti-gay. It was never intended to be anything other than just a kind of,
a
tribute. And it happened because we actually went, we were taken up for this wonderful junket onto Keppel Island and Qantas flew us up and they... And you still have a few of these wonderful sort of gentlemen that have been Qantas stewards for 40 years and they are hilarious and funny and the greatest
and
guys. And fabulous. The other day coming up to... I'm from Melbourne. The other coming up to do the book stuff the other day, I got one of them and I got upgraded and he goes, tell me now, where did you get your inspiration from?
How
I said, well, actually, my friend, and he sat with me for ages up the front, the empty business class, I was saying, aren't you supposed to go back and serving drinks? Ah, bugger him.
Brilliant.
You
was lovely, and it was so much fun. Mm. But look, it was a show of its time. Mm. Fast forward, it would be very hard to make now because it was actually done on the cheap.
Was it?
Yeah.
It must have been so fun though, like working with Magda.
Yeah.
Steve Vizard there, as we saw.
Who? There is no Steve.
No, rings a bell. Yes, Steve was
one. Going.
No, Steve. No,
it should have been Tonight Live with Michael Veitch. That's what I
shouldn't have been.
What about Magda?
I think Steve still has the record for being the first person to fall asleep on live television on his own show. Because he was so exhausted. He was interviewing someone, and I think he actually nodded off one night on live television. So that's pretty heroic.
Have you actually done a skit as well, or a sketch with our Denise?
You did.
Yeah.
In Melbourne Tonight with Frank Holden for a while.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. But didn't we get you on Fast Forward or Full Frontal or something?
No.
Oh, we should have.
No, you probably a send-up of me.
You're probably too expensive, Denise. We couldn't afford you.
Couldn't afford her.
We couldn't have got the costume in time. It had to be made.
But it was the most incredible golden age for comedy because you guys kind of came in and filled the void that the comedy company sort of left behind. Fast Forward sort of really picked up.
Well, they overlapped for it. Really? Oh, that was...
Sorry, look at your little Richard. Face. Yes. That's so funny.
This is a junket at... Look at me. So young. time... What do they say? Time is a terrible thing. I got in trouble for doing Redman here. You see that tie there? Yeah. That is my actual old school tie. And I used to use it doing Redman Herring, and my old school rang me up and said, "Yeah, we are not happy that you're using your old school tie."
God almighty.
You really do hold on to your things, don't you?
But as if they'd really bother. I mean...
If people can find anything to get offended or upset about, they will find it.
I remember the phone call. Can you remember the reason you're wearing your old school tie? Oh. Okay, this teacher that used to abuse me anyway, so he was trying to get some...
You were talking on radio the other day about an accident that almost killed you.
Yeah.
What happened there?
Oh, I'll show you if you like.
Yeah.
You're going to get a camera in here. You can't see it too much now.
That's a real leg,
isn't
it?
Get a close-up. You see that scar there?
There you go, getting
a close-up. All right, well, my... foot was hinged from that point way.
Oh.
What had happened, I was where I live in the Yarra Valley, I was actually cutting down some trees because, you know, I'm a born lumberjack.
In the turtleneck?
In this suit, actually. I'd been going helpful. Sorry if I put my shoe back. I might leave it off.
Yeah, please do. Yeah.
We're all friends.
Freedom. So what happened? You're cutting down a tree.
I was cutting down a brace of very tall eucalyptus obliqua messmate trees, these very springy, fast-growing gum trees, and we were clearing a brace of them that were blocking the light coming into the house over winter. Right. And early in the morning, I cut down a few, and they tilted and got caught up with each other. Mm. So I went away and left it and did some more work and came back at the end of the day, and like a stupid male, if I was a female, I would have had a sensible voice saying,
You're tired.
It's getting dark. Go home. Leave it till tomorrow. Mm. Then I want to get this done.
That's right. It's you versus the tree.
So I went and worked out how they were hanging up, and I was an old dead blackwood in the middle holding them up. I cut that, and as I predicted, the two of them went that way, but the other one that I'd forgotten about that I had also cut went across me, came down there. I remember seeing the bark of this tree, and it somehow managed to clip my leg there, and pile-drived my leg into my ankle.
That's from your leg?
Oh.
That is from your leg?
It hit my... Yeah.
So
it hit,
and then drove that through your... Yeah, and then so flipped it was your...
But there was no pain, strangely enough.
Is there a punchline? Is there something funny that
I'm doing? I'm doing really, really well.
Oh, great stuff.
And they sewed the foot back on, didn't they?
Yeah.
The
punchline is Australia has a great public health system.
There is a comic element to it because when I was lying on the ground there, the ambulance girl ambulance girl came, and she was an inexperienced ambulance girl, and the ambulance her supervisor was working out how to get the truck in because it was in a rural area, and I heard her saying, "Okay, just a sec." Ted, with the morphine, do I break the seal and open valve A first? Or do I And then she gave me 5 mils, and then he came over and said, oh, look at that. How much have you given him? 5 mils. Are you kidding? Look at his foot. Give him 20. And then I was in bliss.
Oh, Michael V.
I'm doing really well.
Yay. We're so glad you're okay. You're a national treasure.